kan. Ya Bu, kita mau ya. Mulai dari awal 10 menit atau tetap 10?
Jam 10.
Ya, maksudnya mau lebih awal kalau udah siap kita mulai sekarang atau mau lagi tunggu lagi?
Dari Thailandnya udah siap semua ya?
Itu yang nurse. Yang nurse underscore PNI itu dekannya Bu ya, yang di
iya.
Yang lainnya sebagian sudah masuk, katanya mereka one by one, nanti nggak sekaligus kayak yang masa kali. Jadi kalau mau dimulai pun nggak apa-apa. Kalau Ibu dari aktornya, dari hostnya sudah siap.
5 menit lagi ya Pak ya, buat tuh naik ke toilet.
Ya, ya nggak apa-apa. Justru karena itu di woro-woro. Woro-woro. Prof Zahra, bagaimana kabarnya Cian, Prof Cian?
No, Prof. Ya, alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. Ya. Yeah. Yeah. So, yeah. Semuanya oke ya di sana?
Oke, okay, semua.
Alhamdulillah.
Jadi
kita tunggulah lepas lepas yeah. Mister Covid ni lari balik ke rumah dia, ke tempat hometown dia, dia jangan datang lagi lah Mister Covid.
Ya, yeah. Yeah, betul. Ya. Mr. Covid datang, datang Mr. David pula nanti lagi.
Ustaz ah, ya, Mr. Covid, Mr. David semua suruh ke, hantar dia orang balik, baliklah, balik kampung, ya, jangan datang
balik
lagi.
Balik kampung, yes. Itu sekarang udah ada Mr. Covid plus pula lagi isunya.
Ya, itu. So, kita sekarang masih lagi, semuanya masih work from home.
Ya. Ya. Prof, itu ada Dean of Nursing Prinadiwas University namanya Saripan, Miss Saripan, mungkin you boleh say hello, Prof.
Hello, Miss Saripan. Daripada mana?
Prinadiwas University, asal dari Thailand.
Ya, apa Selatan. Namanya?
Namanya Miss Saripan.
Hello, Miss Saripan, greetings from me. Nice to meet you virtually. We are very excited to meet in this forum, Miss Saripan. How are you? Welcome to know, to get to know. Which part of Thailand?
Selamat pagi.
Yeah.
Sawadika.
Sawadika, Kak Kurma. Yeah, Sawadika. Yeah, I've been to Thailand. I've been to Thailand few times because used to go to Phuket, Narathiwat, and another one is Songkhla, very near. We go to Songkhla, Bangkok, few years ago. But now this time, no more physical visit. Everything is online. It's good to know you. One day we can meet physically, okay?
Yes, Prof. I have come PNU. Mr. Ali is arranger us.
Yeah.
Yeah, good. Very good. Welcoming PNU when Jakarta Nursing Association come there, Prof. It's very good. Welcome. Thank yeah. you, Miss Saripan, and I mean hi to and apa counselor eh?
Counselor, yeah. Ini di Thailand ni pun bagus. Saya selalu pergi juga dulu di Thailand masa saya dekat Alostar. Dia orang punya apa Songkhla, di mana lagi ya? Chiang Mai. I study in Chiang Mai for gerontology, Miss Saripan, Chiang Mai University.
Chiang Mai
University, yes, Chiang Mai. Very big university. So I went to Chiang Mai, stay there 2 months.
Chiang Mai University.
Yes. For the Asia, for the elderly care,
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Oh,
You study elderly care?
Yes, elderly care. Aged care, aged care, Cheman. Ini apa? Reza ada ramai lecturer kita join ni. Ramai lecturer join ni.
Professor Takul, yes, Reza, do you want to begin now?
เขาไม่ได้ยินอ่ะเขายังจัดหน้าจอเขาอยู่นั่นน่ะๆๆแล้วธงชาติไทยมาตั้งหลังเราบ้างสิของเขาหลายประเทศเหลือเกิน
Professor Takul, Serum Reza, can you hear me? I'm Fusia.
Yeah, Miss Swadika, good morning, Miss Arifon. Thank you for you join.
Do you want to begin now? Because Mandy also is here now.
Oh yeah, it's very nice welcoming from NU while our team nursing college from Jakarta come there. Very nice. Lama nak lupa tu. Boleh cakap Malay tak?
Boleh cakap.
Boleh, okay. So Thai biasanya boleh cakap sikit lah. Miss Arifan, you can speak still Malay language?
Yeah.
Boleh ya.
I can understand, but I couldn't speak. I think it's good. To begin now.
Oh yeah, Miss Arifa, you can look. I use the Thailand too.
Very nice, very nice.
You must pay me a few of idol, my Thailand idol. Oke, Bu, kalau bisa ditanyai, silahkan Ibu Butar atau siapa, Bu Atun, monggo kalau sudah ingin dimulai. Saya nanti pengantar doang ya, habis itu moderator yang atur, saya pun akan dengar saja karena saya pun tak terlalu ngerti nursing, yang ngerti tentang nurse-nya aja. Oke. Prof, bagaimana kabar Tan Sri? Oh, Zahra.
Oh, Tan Sri, sekarang kita sedang bina hospital yang akan siap dalam masa 2 tahun lagi.
Wow.
Hospital dan
kawasan
depan itu depan International School dalam masa 2023 siap dalam 250 katil, siap hospital.
Kemudian, tapi kalau biasa, Prof. Zahra tak begitu, dia tak buat pun.
Dan tepi itu, Alhamdulillah, kita ada buat masjid. Masjid untuk masjid.
Oh, ya.
Saya tahu. Dalam masa 1 tahun. Jadi, semua komplit.
Sebelah kiri, ya. Kalau kita ke masa kampus, sebelah kiri, kan?
Ya, betul.
Okey, kita akan mulai jam 10 on time. Mungkin Pelmi boleh kita start.
Mulai itu.
Boleh Prof, silakan Prof Reza bisa dimulai Prof.
Oh, saya yang menarik bendera start ya.
Iya. Yeah.
Setelah itu serahin Bu Atun ya.
Iya. Yeah.
Oke. Okay. Good morning everybody. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good healthy and funny for you all. Now we will to start of share lecture, international share lecture. Collaboration of Mandala International with Nursing of Pelni Hospital Jakarta and Nursing College of Prithadiwas University Thailand and join to with Mahsa University Malaysia. Very appreciate Prof. Zahra coming in room. It is interesting for us because last minute Prof. Zahra is join and apprise to this event. Only 3 points I will talk for the welcome speech. The first, thank you very much and thank you very much for this Hai, the Nursing College of Prithadiwas with the support of Ms. Taripan and Ms. Karnapan Thai Prasit for this showing lecture. We hope this event not the first and the end, but the first and the 20th event more and more. This is the first. The second, we are very appreciate to student and Prof. Zahra and team of lecturer because last minute I inform about this event is try to join is very appreciate to me. Once more is thank you very much. Terima kasih yang sangat-sangat kepada kawan-kawan, adik-adik, student daripada Malaysia Mahsa Nursing College di atas apresiasi dan join dalam event ini. Ini semua karena saya telah begitu mengenali Prof. Zahra, Prof. Ceam, Prof. Norsia dan lain-lain. Memang Mahsa tidak ada duanya. Jadi ini thank you very much. Yang ketiga kepada Pelni, Nursing College of Pelni, Prof. Zahra sudah tahu masa itu kami datang ramai kepada International Conference. Ms. Saripan, we have introduced Mahsa before that because the campus Mahsa, I hope PNU can do collaboration with Mahsa because Mahsa is very smart nursing college, someone of faculty, but in many faculty more in Mahsa. We hope you can to continue collaboration because Prof. Zahra is a national assessor of nursing and midwifery in Malaysia. I think if not Paul is the title of Prof. Zahra. And Prof. Associate Prof. Buntar, director of Pelni College, is very smart director Prof. Zahra, Ms. Arifan in the Jakarta Nursing College. Is very smart director. Last minute and only one day or half day, I show something is very smart to respond and action. It is amazing director of Nursing College, someone of the best in Jakarta. For your information, RS, this is hospital. Indonesian say rumah sakit. The mean is hospital. Pelni Hospital, 100 oldest hospital, you know, from the Dutch in Indonesia. Therefore, Pelni College Nursing is very more experienced in the nursing college. Therefore, today, this morning, we hope we are happiness because this is sharing lecture, not international conference. We must do. I mean very seriously, but this is Indonesian say Prof. Zahra, sersan. Sersan is serius tapi santai. Yes, I think that you can look a background and my venue. There are flag from Thailand, from Malaysia, Singapore, Philippines, and so on. Because I am is director ASEAN lecturer community. We will do collaboration with another university in ASEAN country. Thank you very much for you all. And I mean, pardon me because lost in this event. But because we are an academic person, we know this is usually in our campus, someone of the little protocol and only, easy for to event. Thank you, Pak Ibu Guntar, Prof. Zahra, Ms. Saripan, and Kanapa Saipasit, Ms. Hayi, and Bapak pemateri dari dari Akbar. Bapak ini kayak biasanya perawan di sarang penyamun nih. Bapak ini jejaka ataupun men di sarang ibu-ibu ya. Jadi bukan penyamun di sarang pihak perawan nih. Ini bukan penyamun nih. Ini sebagai presenter ya, Pak. Okay, only joke. Thank you very much. Hope to you can to discuss is enjoy and happiness. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Kap kum ka.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you, Pak Reza.
Ya.
Terima kasih Prof. Reza sudah mengantarkan. Ya. Terima kasih Prof. Berlebihan menyebut saya. Baiklah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you to everyone for being here today at this Zoom meeting. I am Guntar Handayani, Director of PELNI Academy of Nursing Jakarta, Indonesia. Welcome to International Shared Lectures and University Collaboration of PELNI Academy of Nursing Jakarta and Faculty of Nursing Princess of Naradiwas University Thailand. Before we start our agenda, I would like to express my appreciation to Mrs. Siripan as Dean of Faculty of Nursing, Mrs. Kanapa Chairprasit as Deputy Dean of Faculty of Nursing of Princess of Naradiwas University, Mrs. Fusia Haye as Assistant Professor from Princess of Naradiwas University Thailand, especially from Prof. Zahra, Dean of Mahsa Nursing College Malaysia, Mr. Reza, Director of ASEAN Lectures Community, Mr. Kumaidi, as Lecturer PELNI Nursing Academy of Jakarta, Indonesia, and all happy students from Faculty of Nursing, Princess Naradiwas University Thailand, from Mahsa Nursing College University Malaysia and from PELNI Academy of Nursing Jakarta Indonesia. In today's sharing lecture, we will learn about management and therapy in patients or people with human immunodeficiency virus. Hopefully, that can increase our knowledge and helpful to all of us. Well, I will to hand over it to Mrs. Sriatun, our moderator today. I would like to say once more on behalf of this sharing lecture, welcome and my God blessing us. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention? Okay. I'm sorry. This is a profile company from PELNI.
Sebagai institusi pendidikan yang terkemuka di Jakarta, kami siap mencetak tenaga keperawatan yang bermutu, produktif, kompetitif, dan berkarakter dalam bidang pelayanan keperawatan. Inilah Akademi Keperawatan Pelni Jakarta.
Dengan didukung infrastruktur dan fasilitas pendidikan yang lengkap, serta penyelenggaraan perkuliahan yang bermutu dan terstandar, kami siap mencetak tenaga kesehatan yang kompeten dan berbudi pekerti. Saya, Buntar Handayani. Selamat datang di Akademi Keperawatan Pelni Jakarta.
Berlokasi di jantung barat kota Jakarta, Akademi Keperawatan Pelni sangat strategis dengan akses yang mudah dijangkau. Akademi Keperawatan Pelni Jakarta memiliki lahan praktek laboratorium mini hospital yang mengacu pada bidang keilmuan dan keterampilan. Untuk memenuhi kebutuhan mahasiswa, Akper Pelni juga didukung oleh sarana dan fasilitas penunjang yang lengkap. Untuk menghasilkan tenaga keperawatan yang berkualitas, Akper Pelni memiliki tenaga pengajar yang profesional dan berkompeten dengan latar belakang pendidikan lulusan S1, S2 plus akta, dan S3. Akper Pelni menyediakan berbagai unit kegiatan mahasiswa untuk menyalurkan minat dan bakat para mahasiswa. Sebagai lahan praktek lapangan para mahasiswa untuk melatih keterampilan dan wawasan dalam dunia keperawatan, Akper Pelni telah menjalin kerjasama dengan Rumah Sakit Pelni dan juga berbagai puskesmas yang telah terakreditasi A.
Saya selaku Ketua Yayasan Samudra Apta merespon kebutuhan akan bidang pendidikan bagi bangsa Indonesia. Perubahan kelembagaan dari tingkatan akademi menjadi Institut Teknologi Kemaritiman dan Kesehatan merupakan bukti nyata akan respon kami. Berbagai program studi akan kami siapkan sesuai dengan kebutuhan pangsa pasar saat ini. Bravo untuk Yayasan Samudra Apta!
Lulusan Akper Pelni saat ini telah tersebar di berbagai instansi pemerintah, swasta, puskesmas, dan rumah sakit Pelni sebagai penyerap terbanyak tenaga keperawatan.
Saya, Imadi Wirawan Adiputra, alumni Akademi Keperawatan Pelni Jakarta Angkatan 19. Saat ini saya bekerja di rumah sakit Pelni di unit IGD.
Saya Rizka Dinda Loviana, alumni Akper Pelni Jakarta angkatan ke-20. Saat ini saya bekerja di Rumah Sakit Bakti Mulia sebagai perawat OK.
Saya Lita, alumni Akper Pelni angkatan 18. Saat ini saya bekerja di Rumah Sakit Pelni sebagai perawat anestesi.
Saya Red, alumni Akper Pelni angkatan 6. Saat ini saya bekerja di Jepang sebagai tenaga kesehatan. Bersama Perpelni, saya mendapatkan pengajaran yang bergengsi
dan mampu mengembangkan diri sebagai tenaga kesehatan yang profesional.
Kami bangga
menjadi keluarga besar Akademi Keperawatan
Pelni Jakarta.
Dengan didukung semangat inovasi, kami akan terus mengembangkan diri bagi kemajuan pendidikan keperawatan Indonesia. Akademi Keperawatan Pelni Jakarta siap menjadi yang terdepan.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention before even starting? Any speech from the Faculty of Nursing Princess of Naradivas University? Please time yours. Prof. Silipan.
Selamat pagi.
Selamat pagi.
I'm Silipan. Dean of Faculty of Nursing, Princess of Naradivas University. I'm very happy for the international chair lecture today and university collaboration. It will be a great chance for us to have academic activities. We can develop the academic skill, include nursing knowledge about topic for it. And I hope we still keep in touch and continue this academic activity. Thank you for everyone to share lecture international and Jakarta and PNU, Thailand. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Terima kasih, Prof.
ขอบคุณค่ะ
Honorable Dean Masa University Press from Malaysia Prof. Sabra, Honorable Dean from Faculty of Nursing Princess of Naradivas University, Honorable Director of Academy of Nursing Pelni Jakarta, Honorable Director of ASEAN Lecture Community, Prof. Reza, and Honorable to presenter this event, to Prof. Assistant Prof. Fusia Hai, and to my dean. Ladies and gentlemen, I am moderator today. Event. I am very happy to see you here and welcome all of you. Today meeting is about international chair lecture and university collaboration. Our first speaker today is Assistant Prof. Fusia Hai with the topic The Effect of Symptom Management Combining Aromatherapy Message Program in Fatigue HIV Infection. Please time you. Silakan.
Thank you very much. I'm Fosia Hazi, so thank you for inviting me today.
Selamat pagi. Assalamualaikum.
Selamat pagi.
Sadiqah.
Okay, now. Okay. So for my the topic today.
that sense of those lines.
So I will share my PowerPoint to everyone. Do you have my PowerPoint already? Hello? Do you have my PowerPoint?
Yeah, waiting up a man. You can do information first. How about so Thai now? Okay, it's okay. Rain. Oh, okay.
Okay.
Okay. Rain is here. Your screen very clear.
Okay, thank you. My topic is the effect of symptom management combining aromatherapy massage program on fatigue among HIV infected persons. That is my research that I conducted when I studied a master's degree. However, I also proud to share here again since it was my first research and I did it with my heart to take care of my patients, and I have learned a lot from this research, not only about nursing but also their feeling when a nurse take care of them and as their family. That was an amazing feeling to me. So let me share my research with everyone now, okay? Okay, for the background, why am I in people who live with HIV? Or in its patients, because fatigue is the most common symptom that occurs in this group of disease and it affects the patients most. Fatigue among this group will lead to a chance to get the OI or opportunistic infection, which also results in exacerbation of the progress of disease. They can experience fatigue for all life living with HIV. Fatigue affects the quality of life. About 17 to 60% of people who are living with HIV and 43 to 85% of AIDS patients. In the physical aspect, fatigue can make patients get tired easily, sleep more, but not feel fresh when they wake up, and their body muscle is exhausted. In the aspect of mind, people living with HIV or AIDS cannot concentrate and have big memory and depression. They feel tired all the time. That's why fatigue management is the most important in this group. I think someone may think about the causes of fatigue. Of course, we should think about the causes of fatigue. So it can come from the physical causes. So let me ask my student, could you share or give some example the causes from the physical that can that is caused for the fatigue in the physical cause? Could you give my example in the physical aspect?
Anemia,
okay. And oh, I see that in Indonesia you can check the example too. Some of my students give the example is anemia, also is the cause of fatigue. What else?
Infection.
Some infection like OI, right? Anything else? Okay, you can give the example of like in my aspects. You can give me example of the causes from the mind.
Worry about family.
Worry about their family and anything else.
About economic.
Economy and worry about their disease also, right? So yes, of course. Thank you for your giving more example to us. So, like all the example that can make them more fatigued. So, there are many fatigue management methods that can release fatigue. Moreover, from the literature review, I found that multiple methods should be mixed to be more effective in releasing fatigue than just one method. As in this research, we use massage and aromatherapy to release fatigue among people who are living with HIV. Massage, it is like a power of touch. But I think everyone here also loves massage. Also me too. Do you like massage? Yes. Massaging can help blood circulation, increase relaxation feeling, decrease strictness of the muscle, and encourage sleep. Especially we use massaging with aroma, which relax the nervous system. Called aroma is a part of complementary therapy. It uses the smells of aroma or extracted from the nature. It is a chemistry element such as, like everyone know, lavender oil. That is alcoholic volatile oil. This substance has the property of sterilizing the disease, resisting the virus and healing the skin. In this study, we use bergamot oil. Bergamot oil, like in Thai called madu. I'm not sure in Indonesia, what do you call the bergamot? Bergamot? Is it actually madu? What do you call bergamot in Indonesia?
What masyad urut?
Oh, masa urut.
Pijat.
Pijat.
Pijat. Pijat.
Okay. Then we use for use the oil of the bergamot to be aromatherapy in this study. So. Yes, because the property to decrease the contraction of smooth muscle make calm and give relaxation feeling. When the patient smell the aroma that they like, the aroma endorphin and make the patient feel relaxed. So this is the reason why I use a massage combined with aromatherapy as symptom management to decrease fatigue among people who are living with HIV. For the objective of this research, the aim of this study was to study the effect of symptom management combining aromatherapy massage program, the intervention, and between experimental and control group. For the this is a bergamot, like everyone said, acetylmorphine. And this is aromatherapy. This is a power of touch. And for the methodology, of course, we use AQUASA experimental research as a research design. The sample of this study was HIV-infected persons, or now today we use the word of people who living with HIV, who visited at their OPD in the tertiary hospital, Southern Thailand. 40 subjects were purposely selected. The first 20 subjects were assigned to the control group and received routine nursing care. And the later 20 subjects were assigned to the experimental group and received the symptom management combining aromatherapy massage program. Both groups were similar with regard to sex, age, opportunities, infection, antiretroviral medication use, and duration of resting time per day. For instruments used for data collection consists of demographic data form and the HIV-related fatigue scales. The instruments were validated by a 5 expert tested for reliability using combat alpha. Combat alpha does yield a value of
0.94 for the entire scale. The HRFS consisted three dimension of fatigue, that is intensity, circumstance surrounding fatigue, and consequences of fatigue. The reliability is accepted. For the outcome of this program will reported in terms of fatigue severity index, intensity score, and overall fatigue related functioning score. And for the inclusion criteria of this study, male and female at the OPD who have fatigue and over the age of 18 years and having fatigue before intervention, there are no allergy history and love smell of bergamot aroma. If they don't like the smell, it should not is our participants. So no disease condition of diabetes mellitus or OI cancer. For the exclusion criteria, the participant with the lesion on the body or other problems such as thrombosis or fibritis were excluded. So for our finding, you can see in the table, after intervention, that means post test, subject in the experimental group reported significantly lower intensity score, overall fatigue related functioning score, and fatigue severity index score than before, lower score than before intervention. And post interventions, the participant in the experimental group is also lower intensity score, overall fatigue related functioning score, and fatigue severity index score than the control group too. So the result of you can see as this picture, you can see more clearly that the post-test scores were lower than pre-test score. But I'm sorry for this description of this picture in Thai, edition for English. But I think everyone can understand. Do you have any question? So I think you can see that it's more clear for this picture. So the results of this study show that use of pseudomonas when combining aromatherapy massage program was helpful in reducing the level of fatigue in people who are living with HIV. So if you have any questions, you can ask me. You can
understand.
Thank you.
Bahasa Jakarta. Not at all.
So fast, I speak so fast. Okay, I'm sure my best is for my conclusion, that is we can conclude that my intervention program can decrease the fatigue among people who are living with HIV. And also for the recommendation, before that fatigue reduced when participants receive symptom management combining aromatherapy massage program, almost all of the participants felt more relaxed and energized after a session. So we recommend that caregiver can perform aromatherapy massage as a part of self-care for family and home care community to improve quality of life. Of course, as a nurse, we can take care of our patients as a holistic care, not only in physical, mental, and social aspect, but also in the spiritual aspect too. So this picture, these are pictures when I did the research at that time. They were massaged by me. This is my patient that were massaged by me by using bergamot oil as well. Can you massage them?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, I studied massage with aromatherapy school, and I got the certificate from the aromatherapy school in Bangkok. Yeah. Before I did this research. And how, of course, I know everyone may think about the infection from them, right? But of course, I really careful for self-assessment whether I was ready or not before I must ask them. When this study was finished, got allergy, and they are safe from this research, as they have to comply with research ethic too. Everyone was happy and good continue to do at their home. This is I must say by myself, and this this is CD4 just lower than 200. I think that I'm really amazing for her, but she very strong. After that, she really happy when I massage her. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, do you have any questions? Thank you.
Okay, good presentation. Nice.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Oh, giving presentation on informative and interesting topic.
Yeah.
And then second speaker.
Mr. Humaydi.
Nurse Humaydi, time is yours.
Yeah, monggo, Mas.
Please stop screen.
Stop screen, please. Stop screen. Thank you.
Usia, please you. Okay, thank you. We will the shipping of Pelni. Shipping hospital Pelni. Okay, the student from Malaysia and Thailand must be to prepare your question for the both speaker. Special gift amazing from Pelni Tanah Abang, Jakarta.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Salam clear.
Okay, selamat pagi. Thank you for Mrs. Sriatu. Good morning everyone. Good morning Mrs. Siripan from the Princess of Naradiwas University Thailand. Good morning Mrs. Zahra from the Mahsa University. Good morning Mrs. Buntar Handai Yani, good morning Mr. Reza, dan good morning all happy student from Pelni Nursing Academy, from Princess of Naradiwas University Thailand, and student from Mahsa University, College University Malaysia. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, in this special occasion, I would like to present my writing about HIV. And the title of writing is Antiretroviral Therapy Side Effects Management in People Living with HIV. Okay. Okay, these are the outline presentation that I delivered to you. Okay, let me start from the definition. I believe that you are familiar about HIV, right? Okay, HIV or human immunodeficiency virus is a retroviral that attacks the immune system. What the immune system? The immune system is a thing in our body that protect our body from the bacteria, from the virus, from the fungus, from the severe disease and other microorganism. Okay. Immune system like a house that protect us from the sun and the rain. And then AIDS. AIDS is a syndrome. A syndrome is several condition or illness. In the case of the HIV infection, they happen because the virus weaken the immune system. AIDS appear where the immune system or CD4 or antibody decrease in our blood and the viral load of HIV increases. Okay, the next, antiretroviral therapy or ART is the medicine that reduces the amount of HIV in the body. As a result, the body's immune system can fight off disease and the person can become healthy again. A person with HIV must take antiretroviral drug every time, every day for the rest of his or her life for the treatment to be effective. Okay, there are causes of HIV transmission. Someone can get HIV via first sex with unknown partner or multiple partner without condom, and then pass from mother to baby. When the HIV can infect baby or child from the mother to baby, first when the mother during pregnant, when the mother during delivery the baby, and when the mother during breastfeeding, and then HIV can infect someone when sharing injecting equipment and contaminate blood transfusion and organ transplants. Okay, how to treatment HIV? Yeah. Sorry, I have trouble. Okay, how to treatment HIV? We can treatment HIV using antiretroviral therapy. There are three kinds of antiretroviral therapy. The first, necrosis reverse transcriptase inhibitor, consists of zidovudine, lamivudine, tafudine, and tenofovir. And second, non-nucleosid reverse transcriptase inhibitor consists of nevirapine and efavirenz. And the last, protease inhibitor consists of ritonavir or lopinavir. And what the difference of the NRTI and NRTI than protease inhibitor? Nucleosid and the nucleosid reverse transcriptase group of ART work in dissimilar ways. They prevent HIV from entering the infected cell center so HIV can make new copies or can make new virus. And how about protease inhibitor? Protease inhibitor prevent the assembly of the HIV parts and thus prevent the HIV virus from coming out from the infected CD4 cells. Okay, this is a combination of ART in Indonesia. There are Lini 1, Lini 2, and Lini 3. In Lini 1, a combination 2 NRTI and 1 NRTI. For example, tenofovir plus lamivudine and plus efavirenz, or tafudine plus lamivudine and plus efavirenz of nevirapine. And for Lini 2, combination 2 NRTI and 1 protease inhibitor. For example, tafudine plus lamivudine plus lopinavir, or tenofovir plus lamivudine or plus lopinavir. And in Lini 3, we will give the patient with HIV etravirine or ritonavir. Okay, what are the goals of ART? First, to reduce the concentration of the HIV virus in the blood as much as possible, and to increase the number of CD4 cells as much as possible too. And then, ART drug reduces the HIV concentration in the blood. The immune system recovers and the number of healthy CD4 cell increases. Okay, before we move into other slide, I'm going to play the video. Mr. Danny, can you help me to play the video?
Nowadays, HIV is a manageable long-term condition. This is a virus called HIV. It has one thing on its mind, making more copies of itself, regardless of the damage that it will do to the body. These are CD4 cells, also called helper cells. They are part of the immune system and are the body's defense against attack from unwelcome bacteria and viruses. But when a HIV virus attacks a CD4 cell, it gets inside the cell and starts making copies of itself. Eventually, the CD4 cell dies, releasing more HIV into the body, which in turn attack more CD4 cells. Without additional support, the CD4 cells are quickly overwhelmed by HIV viruses. With CD4 defenses lowered and HIV multiplying, the body becomes vulnerable to attack from other infections. However, there are several treatments available to help CD4 cells fight back. This involves taking a combination of drugs that help the CD4 cells to protect themselves against HIV. Starting treatment as soon as possible after being diagnosed with HIV and taking treatment that's right for the body keeps CD4 cells armed against HIV and able to protect the body from serious, life-threatening illnesses. It is important to take treatment regularly to help your CD4 cells continue to fight off HIV. Effective treatment taken correctly means that people with HIV can lead full and healthy lives.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Danny. Maybe I want to explain more about this video in Bahasa. Jadi, di video tadi ditunjukkan bahwa ketika virus HIV masuk ke dalam tubuh kita, dia akan menyerang yang namanya sel CD4. Jadi sel CD4 adalah salah satu sel yang memprotek tubuh kita dari gangguan mikroorganisme yang masuk dari luar tubuh kita. Nah, ketika virus HIV sudah masuk ke dalam tubuh, dia akan menyerang yang namanya CD4. Jadi nanti CD4-nya itu akan diinfeksi oleh si HIV-nya. Jadi HIV nanti akan merusak CD4, kemudian setelah merusak CD4 nanti dia akan berkembang biak atau dia akan memperbanyak diri di dalam tubuh CD4 tersebut. Setelah memperbanyak diri, kemudian nanti akan merusak CD4 yang lainnya. Kemudian tadi saya sudah jelaskan bahwa untuk treatment HIV itu yaitu dengan menggunakan antiretroviral terapi. Jadi antiretroviral terapi itu adalah gabungan dari beberapa obat antiretroviral. Jadi tujuan dari pemberian obat antiretroviral ini untuk membuat si CD4 itu terlindungi dari virus HIV. Jadi ketika orang dengan HIV mengkonsumsi ART, nanti si CD4 itu akan memiliki perlindungan. Ketika si virusnya menyerang, dia nanti tidak bisa menyerang si CD4-nya. Sehingga tujuan dari pemberian antiretroviral terapi itu selain meningkatkan CD4 di dalam tubuh kita, sekaligus juga menurunkan jumlah viral load di dalam tubuh kita. Okay, I'm going to continue my slide. Okay. in this slide, I'm going to explain about how does ART help controlling HIV epidemic. HIV medicine are not a cure for HIV. And then it reduces the threats, prolonged lives, improve quality of life, recognize hope in communities, and has transformed HIV to manageable condition. And antiretroviral therapy treatment can add many years of healthy life to HIV positive person. And then availability of HIV treatment encourages people to volunteer for HIV testing as they now see a hope. If diagnosed, early people can seek care and initiate treatment at the right time and not wait until they are sick with symptoms. And stigma and discrimination are also likely to reduce since more people will be able to be open about their status, work, and contribute to the community. Okay, for the next slide, I want to explain about antiretroviral therapy side effect management. Okay, di sini saya akan sedikit menjelaskan kenapa kita perlu menginformasikan atau mengedukasi pasien dengan HIV/AIDS yang mengkonsumsi antiretroviral therapy terkait side effect-nya. Yang pertama, itu adalah hak dari pasien untuk mengetahui bagaimana efek samping dari obat yang kita berikan. Kemudian, client can better prepare themselves. Jadi, ketika kita sudah menjelaskan efek samping dari pengobatan tersebut, client itu sudah betul-betul siap ketika mereka mendapatkan efek samping dari obat tersebut. And then client can better understand that not all side effects present the same level of seriousness or long-term impact. And then client can better understand the importance of seeking help early. Jadi ketika kita sudah menjelaskan efek samping dari pengobatan ART itu, mereka nanti akan berinisiatif untuk mencari bantuan secepat mungkin. Karena apa? Karena efek samping dari obat ART ini selain membuat ketidaknyamanan, tetapi juga nanti akan berdampak terhadap ketidakpatuhan. Jadi pasien yang menggunakan antiretroviral terapi ini ketika mendapatkan efek samping dari pengobatan ART akan kemungkinan besar untuk tidak meminum lagi obatnya. Nanti kepatuhan pengobatannya akan berkurang. Apa akibatnya ketika kepatuhan pengobatan ART itu terganggu atau pasiennya tidak patuh terhadap pengobatan? Yang pertama, nanti CD4-nya akan menurun. Kalau CD4-nya akan menurun, otomatis tidak ada perlindungan lebih dari tubuh si pasien tersebut. Yang kedua, viral load-nya akan meningkat. Jadi ketika pasien dengan HIV itu tidak menggunakan ART, nanti viral load-nya akan semakin meningkat. Jadi berbanding terbalik dengan CD4-nya. Jadi CD4-nya itu akan semakin menurun, sedangkan si viral load-nya itu akan semakin meningkat. Nah, apa yang terjadi kalau viral load-nya semakin meningkat? Orang dengan HIV kalau viral load-nya semakin meningkat, nanti akan mengakibatkan beberapa penyakit-penyakit itu dapat menginfeksi pasien-pasien tersebut. Contohnya tuberkulosis, hepatitis, dan beberapa penyakit-penyakit lainnya. Oke, in this slide I want to explain about common antiretroviral side effect and how to manage. The first, headache. What we do or what we educate our patient, they have headache. First, rub the base of head with thumb or temper gently and rest in quiet dark room with eyes closed. And place cold clothes over for head and avoid things with caffeine such as coffee, strong tea, and sodas. And take one tablet of paracetamol. And then we educate our patient to go to clinic if vision become blurry and unfocused. And then aspirin doesn't stop the pain and have frequent or very painful headaches. And the second, dry mouth. We educate our patient to rinse mouth with clean warm water and salts and avoid sweets and avoid things with caffeine such as coffee, strong tea, and sodas. And we suggest our patient to go to clinic if have spot or tongue or in mouth and have trouble swallowing food. And then skin rashes. Skin rashes, we can suggest our patient to wash often with unscented soap and water, keep the skin clean and dry, use calming lotion to soothe itching, and avoid the sun when has a rash. And go to clinic if the side effect persists and visit the doctor for consultation. And the next, diarrhea. Diarrhea, we suggest our patient to eat meals more time a day and eat easy food and drink lots of clean boiled water and take oral rehydration salts and avoid spicy or fried food. And we suggest to go to clinic if there is a blood in the stools and have diarrhea more than 4 to 8 times a day and also have the fever and thirsty but cannot eat or drink properly. And then feeling dizzy. If feeling dizzy, sit down until the feeling goes away and try not to lift anything heavy or more quickly and take efavirenz right before going to sleep because efavirenz have side effect is feeling dizzy. And then if the side effect persists, visit doctor for consultation. And then nausea and vomiting. We suggest our patient to eat lots of small meals rather than big meals and take sip of clean boiled water with tea or oral rehydration salt until the vomiting stop and avoid spicy or fried food. And we suggest our patient to go to clinic if have sharp pain in stomach. Also have fever, there is blood in the vomit, vomiting lasts more than a day, and very thirsty, but cannot eat or drink properly. And the last, feeling of sadness or worry. We suggest to talk about their feeling with others and go to clinic for consultation if have serious sad or very worried thought. And thinking about killing themselves and very aggressive or very scared. And I think that's all my presentation. Thanks for nice attention. I'm ready for suggestion or question.
Thank you, Mr. Kumaydi. Ladies and gentlemen, now it's time for the question and association. The chat room, any question from student from Pelni, Nuri Atinanima, ini untuk Pak Kum ya, bagaimana cara mengontrol seseorang yang terkena HIV? And then from Siti Sundari, to Prof. Fusia, what types of aromatherapy can be used for among HIV infection person besides the skin bergamot? And two, when should we do the aromatherapy message and how long this duration? Please, the presenter,
has answer? Pak Kumaldi dulu.
And the first. From Nuri. Nuri is my student. Nuri, can I answer your question in bahasa? Okay, bagaimana cara mengontrol seseorang yang terkena HIV? Jadi, I want to ask you, what the mean mengontrol seseorang yang terkena HIV? Maksudnya gimana Nuri? Apakah mengontrol dia untuk tidak menularkan ke orang lain atau mengontrol dia untuk menggunakan obat-obat ART-nya secara rutin atau bagaimana?
Tidak menggunakan obatnya.
Rutin menggunakan obatnya. Oke. Okay. Bagaimana cara kita supaya pasien kita yang terkena HIV itu menggunakan obat secara rutin? Yang pertama, sebelum dia mengkonsumsi obat, biasanya kita itu langsung mengedukasi pasiennya. Biasanya kita langsung kasih konseling. Jadi ada namanya konseling sebelum pemberian obat antiretroviral terapi. Jadi kita menjelaskan, ibu, bapak, ini obatnya. Ini obat yang bapak ibu harus konsumsi. Ini jenis obatnya. Ini adalah dosis obatnya. Kemudian yang kedua, kita menjelaskan bagaimana efek samping dari obat ART tersebut. Jadi kita jelaskan, ibu, obat ini obat ini punya efek samping misalkan diare. Nah, obat ini punya efek samping pusing. Jadi kita jelaskan efek samping dari pengobatan tersebut. Kenapa kita harus menjelaskan efek samping dari pengobatan? Karena kalau kita menjelaskan efek samping dari pengobatan, nanti kalau mereka ketika mengkonsumsi obat ART tersebut mendapatkan efek samping tersebut, nanti mereka cepat mencari bantuan atau cepat mencari informasi ke dokter atau perawat, sehingga mereka tidak akan mencari informasi-informasi yang belum tentu benar. Kemudian, selanjutnya yang perlu dilakukan oleh seorang perawat atau seorang dokter supaya si pasien ini tetap patuh terhadap pengobatan adalah selalu mengontrol pengobatan tersebut. Jadi biasanya si pasien itu akan berkunjung setiap bulannya untuk kontrol kemudian untuk mengambil obat-obat ART. Nah, ketika mereka datang untuk mengambil obat-obatan tersebut, kita edukasi lagi, ibu, bagaimana obat yang dikonsumsi selama sebulan ini, apakah rutin diminum, apakah ada efek samping, kalau ada efek samping apa yang ibu lakukan. Nah, itu yang perlu kita tanyakan ke pasien kita ketika mereka datang dan memiliki keluhan efek samping. Jadi kita memberi support yang lebih kepada mereka supaya mereka itu mau mengkonsumsi obat tersebut. Dan kita juga menjelaskan bahwa obat ART ini, obat antiretroviral terapi ini dikonsumsi seumur hidup. Nah, jadi dikonsumsi umur hidup. Jadi kita edukasi pasiennya untuk mengkonsumsi secara rutin. Karena kenapa? Kalau tidak dikonsumsi secara rutin, nanti jumlah CD4 itu akan menurun, akan semakin menurun dari hari ke hari apabila tidak mengkonsumsi obat ART secara patuh atau secara berkelanjutan. Oke.
Okay. Terima kasih, Pak.
Thank you, Pesan Kumaydi. Ada lagi, please, Miss Kusia. Can you answer?
Okay, let me answer Miss So
Siti Sundari.
For the question is so many questions.
What type?
It's for my research. It's up to the aromatherapy come from the nature. It's not someone maybe don't want to use bergamot, but they can use other smell like a bergamot from lavender. Most. Normally, they someone use like a lavender, but for my research, use bergamot because I think in our culture and family a bit bergamot or like a lime is also is okay, but it's also easy to find in our places. So and also like a lavender is expensive, but we focus on what they like because if they like the smell, it can help like when we smell the some smell from the aroma, the smell will come to the limbic system. It can release the endorphin that make them to relax, feel relaxed. That's why. If you would like to use some aromatherapy with your HIV patient, you can use everything. However, we have to concern about allergy because someone can allergy some aroma oils. We have to test first. Even my research, I have to test first, and then I monitor. If they allergy, we don't include in our study. So we have to test the aroma oil elbow, the skin elbow here. So if they don't allergy, we can use that aroma. Okay.
คำถามยังไงแล้วอ่ะ
Thank you.
Oh, and you answer how long?
How long?
As in this study, we use 3 days continue every day. For 3 days, massage every day, 3 days for 2 weeks, and then we measure for the outcome or for the post test, and we got the outcome.
Thank you, Miss.
Thank you, Miss. And then a question from student Elni. Tuh, Kumaidia, bagaimana cara mengontrol seorang yang terkena HIV agar tidak terjadi AIDS? Yang tidak sampai terjadi AIDS, berarti cara mengontrol. Tidak terjadi HIV. Jadi ada dua. Udah. Any question from Sulistianing Room? I want to ask, have been teaching after doing an aromatherapy message program about fatigue in HIV infected people.
Excuse me, do you mean the question from Audi, right?
Sulistianing Room. From Sulistianing Room. From Akur Pelni. Yes. Silakan di standing room mau bertanya. Bisa langsung.
Standing room. Okay. Could you give me the questions again, please? Because I can't hear for a hearing. Could you give me the question again, please?
Okay. Yeah.
Could you give me the question again, please?
Mr. and Mrs. Fusie, maybe after massage, what the happened to the patient? Maybe like that, and maybe feel relaxed or the other feel. So we standing room, right?
Okay.
After I feel, we have done with the this research. Of course, with their skin will like give more moisture, that receive more moisture, and also they feeling relaxed. How they got relaxed? As I mentioned before about the mechanism of the massage, that can help them to blood circulation. Help them to feeling relaxed from the like a massage or also aromatherapy can help them for the element of compound. help them to release the endorphins.
So,
thank you. Bagaimana Sulistianing Room? Dan jawabannya? Next us to Siti Sundari.
And this why and some question, why actually patient with body skin lesion or other problems such as thrombosis are not recommended to use aromatherapy massage? Because if they have some disease or like a lesion on their skin, it will if we use the aromatherapy, make them for inflammatory on their skin because they have the lesion. So it's like some limitation. They don't allow to do the aroma. We also don't recommend to use the aromatherapy. It's not only HIV person. It's for people who are living with HIV.
Thank you, Miss. Any question to Mr. Kumaidi? Please, you ask. From Siti Sundari.
What the question, Mrs. Atun? What are the risks when patients forget or stop retrovirus therapy without advice from clinical teams, right? Mrs. Sundari? Okay, and the second question, is it true that HRV therapy in pregnant women infected HIV AIDS infection can prevent to fetus HIV AIDS infection? May I answer in Bahasa, Mrs. Sundari?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What are the risks when patient forget? Okay. What the risk if patient stop or forget consume at antiretroviral therapy, okay? Jika pasien ini lupa minum obat, tadi saya sudah jelaskan, kalau lupa nanti their CD4 increase and their viral load CD4 to going decrease and viral load to going increase. Jadi ketika kita pasien itu tidak mengkonsumsi obat atau menghentikan pengobatannya, nanti viral load-nya akan meningkat dan CD4-nya akan menurun. Kalau viral load-nya sudah meningkat, nanti kalau CD4-nya sudah menurun, nanti tidak ada protek dari si CD4-nya itu, tidak ada yang melindungi tubuh kita dari ancaman dari luar seperti virus, seperti bakteri dan seperti mikroorganisme lainnya. Jadi ketika obatnya di stop, maka si pasien ini akan berisiko tinggi mengalami AIDS. Jadi dari HIV yang tanpa gejala akan mengalami AIDS jika obatnya di stop. And how about is it true that antiretroviral therapy in pregnant women infected HIV AIDS infection can prevent to fetus or to baby? And mother HIV positive has a baby can prevent HIV infected their baby if he use or consume antiretroviral therapy. when CD4 increase or viral load decrease, he HIV can infected their baby, and HIV can transmit to their baby. Okay, you get it?
Yes, sir. Sure. What this do immediately when the forget HIV? Apa yang harus dilakukan segera ketika ketika pasien tersebut lupa untuk meminum obatnya? Ketika itu efeknya. Nah, apa yang harus segera dilakukan?
Yang dilakukan segera suruh minum obatnya lagi. Itu adalah salah satu kuncinya, minum obatnya lagi dan kita edukasi untuk rutin minum obatnya. Hanya itu saja.
Oh, jadi ya. Tidak ada terapi tambahan atau penaikan terapi tambahan obat terapi untuk dosisnya tidak?
Kalau dia tidak memiliki infeksi oportunistik, jadi kita hanya mengedukasi pasiennya untuk kembali minum obatnya secara rutin.
Terima kasih. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Ya,
terima kasih, welcome. Pak Pum. Ada pertanyaan lain lagi, Pak Pum? Siap ada di chat room banyak. Kemudian to Miss Julia, please, from Akademi Perliana, from Akademi Universiti. Based on conclusion of the intervention program, this method of using aromatherapy and music to help a relaxation for its HIV patient be the most effective program. If so, why is that? Audi, kalau mau bertanya langsung silahkan.
Ini pertanyaannya.
Audi, Feliana, Burayu.
Ya, Ibu.
Ya, silahkan bertanya. Langsung. Maksudnya, sampaikan maksudnya apa?
Saudi.
Diulang.
I would like to ask Ms. Kusia, based on conclusion of the intervention programs, is that method of using aromatherapy and massage to help a relaxation for HIV patient be the most effective programs? And why? Thank you.
Thank you for this question. Of course, and before that, this program can release the fatigue. However, we have some limitation of the resource. Selecting a sample, we use a purposely sampling. Also, is one of some limitation of the resource. We cannot conclude that this is the most effective. However, we can conclude that if the patient have the similar condition like this research, we can use this program and we believe that this program can help and release their fatigue. Did you get this answer?
Yes. Thank you for the answer, Miss.
Thank you.
Any question from Redita? Redita Fernanda. Redita. Ya, diulang kembali pertanyaannya.
Is aromatherapy popular in teenagers? What factor aromatherapy can be popular?
Suaranya kecil, Fredita.
Oh, iya, Bu. Pertanyaan saya sama kayak di chat room. Itu, is aromatherapy popular on teenagers? what factor aromatherapy can be popular? Thank you.
Thank you, Renita.
Renita,
our senior student. You are great at giving questions. So, as your question, popular. I think for the old patient, older is more popular than teenager. Because but most people use like bergamot, bergamot, lime, anything else? In country house, no. But for teenager, I rare people to use. But when they go to the spa or massage or the like a. What we call massage restaurant. sometimes they use the service as hospital. Mostly it's not teenager. Yes, but in my study there is some student 18 years old. They told me they like but it's not popular, but we can, as a nurse, we can give this knowledge, this information to their family or to teenager, that they can, if they have a relative who have people who living with HIV, they can suggestion, they can give information to their family, right? That can help them to release the fatigue. So as you are a teenager, you got this knowledge, you can tell someone who know that maybe it's I think we should not call popular, but mostly used it. Okay, thank you.
Okay,
miss,
thank you very much for the answer.
Welcome.
Thank you. And then any question from Nadila Nur Hanifah to Miss Fauzia.
You know.
Hello, my name is Nadila Nurhanifah. I want to ask this Fauzia, is the aromatherapy which program only?
Suaranya mungkin kurang jelas.
My name is Nadila Nurhanifah from the Department of Academic Education. I want to ask this Fauzia, is the aromatherapy which program only intended for HIV? Infected people to relieve the COVID, or can it be done to prevent HIV infection?
Mungkin diulang, diulang pertanyaan.
This one is not clear, but I can read from the chat. Literature review of a further aromatherapy and with massage can use with other diseases such as cancer. Cancer to relieve fatigue. However, this massage with aroma could not prevent HIV infection. That you learn from Dr. Kamkumadi. The method to prevent HIV infection, using condom, avoid to have sex with other people like this. It's not bad for mine, just release fatigue, okay? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Then question from Agil. Please, Mr. Kumaydi, answer.
Okay, what the difference between antiretroviral therapy and antiretroviral drugs for someone who has HIV? Okay, what the difference of antiretroviral therapy and antiretroviral drugs? Antiretroviral drugs we use or consume for people living with HIV. I think drugs for people living with HIV. And antiretroviral therapy is combination of antiretroviral drugs. Agil, you get it?
Yeah. Mister, thank you.
Okay.
Question from Agil. Mr. Kumaydi, please. From Henny. From Henny Sartina. How to prevent HIV transmission from pregnant woman to fetus?
Okay, how to prevent HIV transmission from pregnant woman to baby, maybe to baby, yeah. Okay, how to prevent HIV transmission from pregnant woman to their baby, okay. First, we must suggest the woman with positive HIV to consult to a doctor or nurse, and second, we must suggest them to consume antiretroviral therapy, and if he consume antiretroviral therapy regularly and continue, viral load will going to decrease and CD4 will going to increase, and then the HIV can prevent from the woman pregnant to their baby. You get it, Henny?
Any question from Selfie?
Matip.
For Selfie, I'm going to ask Mr. Kumaydi if the summer is safe to have HIV when he starts antiretroviral treatment.
Mana sih itu, Bu?
Selfie Apriliani.
Selfie
Apriliani. Kapan diberikan ART? Mulai diberikan
ART. Selfie, can I answer in Indonesia again? Kapan diberikan terapi antiretroviral? Jadi pasien yang sudah terinfeksi HIV akan diberikan terapi antiretroviral itu ketika pasiennya sudah melakukan pemeriksaan apakah dia untuk memastikan apakah dia sudah positif HIV atau tidak. Ketika sudah positif HIV, hasil labnya itu sudah positif HIV, nanti langsung diedukasi untuk mengkonsumsi obat antiretroviral terapi. Jadi ketika si pasien HIV itu sudah dinyatakan positif, kita akan langsung berikan terapi antiretroviral. Jadi obatnya akan langsung diberikan. Jadi nggak menunggu waktu lagi, nunggu 1 bulan atau 2 bulan. Tapi kalau si pasiennya memiliki infeksi oportunistik seperti tuberkulosis, biasanya kita mengobati tuberkulosisnya dulu selama 2 minggu. Jadi kita kasih dulu obat tuberkulosisnya selama 2 minggu, baru kita memberikan obat HIV-nya, seperti itu.
Ya, terima kasih, Kumaydi. And then question from Ajeng Lare to Miss Fusia. Ajeng Lare, Kajeng Lari, silakan bertanya langsung, boleh?
Ya, Ibu.
Ya.
My special to ask, why high patients with body skin lesions or other problems such as thrombocyte are not recommended to use aromatherapy message methodology?
Thrombosis ya, thrombosis. Recommended or not? Halo, Miss Lucia. Please, your answer.
Mrs. Fusie, your microphone still off. Miss Fusie, your microphone, please. Please unmute your microphone.
Could you give me the question again, please?
Why HIV patients with body skin lesions or other problems such as thrombosis are not recommended to use aromatherapy message methodology?
Yes, it is the same question, right? I have answered already that the aromatherapy is a aroma oil that cannot use with the skin lesion because it really can lead them to have a infection or inflammatory on their skin. So we should avoid to use aroma oil. It's not only HIV infected HIV person or people who living with HIV, but also we. Everyone should avoid when we have a lesion skin. Do you get the answer?
Enggak untuk speakernya. Enggak untuk speakernya.
Okay.
Thank you, Miss. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we have finally come to the end of this meeting. Before I close the event, I want to draw conclusion from what the present said. Please, Mr. Kumaydi. Please, Mr. Kumaydi, have you saw conclusion this event?
Okay, thank you, Miss Triatun Wahyuni.
I'm sorry, Miss Fusi.
I want to conclude today. There is many knowledge we can get from this event. We can, Mrs. Fusie has explained about how to manage fatigue in people with living with HIV, and me has to explain about how to manage such effect of patient with HIV. And I think a student in here can get many knowledge that has you here, and maybe you can do it to your patient when you has a nurse, when you work in hospital. And I think that's all.
Thank you, Mr. Kuwaidi. Yeah. I would like to thank the speaker for the informative and interesting presentation, and all participants.
for their very active participant. And finally, give the speaker a round of applause and for all of you. Thank you. Biletek Walidaya, wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, before we are going to photo together. Okay, Mr. Denny, can you capture this Zoom?
Okay, thank you very much.
Please open your camera.
Okay.
On your camera.
Open your camera.
Siap ya foto ya. 1, 2, 3.
Ayo stel.
1, 2, 3. Okay. One more. 1, 2, 3. Okay. 1, 2, 3.
Beda-beda.
Sudah, Bu. Selebihnya nggak ada video yang on. Sudah.
Thank you very much to everyone.
Terima kasih semuanya. Mohon maaf bila ada kesalahan.
But we got a lot we got the knowledge from you, and we are very happy to collaborate.
Thank you.
University. Okay, we hope we can meet again. You can see again.
Thank you. See you next time.
You're welcome.
Another event.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
See you next time. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Sistem
moderator kan
di sana.
Marah baik, ditodong.
Hmm.